Hey everyone, this is Mary DeMuth and this is Pray Every Day, where I pray through the Bible verse by verse. This is brought to you by Outrageous Grace Every Day, which is a 90-day devotional through the book of Romans. And that's put out by Harvest House Publishers, and you can find it wherever books are sold. In celebration of that, we're reading through the book of Romans in December and January. Right now, we're making a pretty fast clip. We're in Romans 10, verses 1 through 10, and this is in the easy-to-read version, ERV. It says this: Brothers and sisters, what I want most is for all the people of Israel to be saved. That is my prayer to God. I can say this about them. They really try hard to follow God, but they don't know the right way. They did not know the way that God makes people right with Him, and they tried to make themselves right in their own way. So they did not accept God's way of making people right. Christ ended the law so that everyone who believes in Him is made right with God. Moses writes about being made right by following the law. He says, the person who obeys these laws is the one who will have life through them. But this is what the scriptures say about being made right through faith. Don't say to yourself, who will go up into heaven? This means, who will go up to heaven to get Christ and bring him down to earth? And don't say, who will go down into the world below? This means, who will go down to get Christ and bring him up from the death? This is what the scripture says. God's teaching is near to you. It is in your mouth and in your heart. It is the teaching of faith that we tell people. If you openly say Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from death, you will be saved. Yes, we believe in Jesus deep in our hearts so we are made right with God, and we openly say that we believe in him, and so we are saved. Mind if I pray for you? Lord Jesus, this is a big word, save, and it's been wrestled about so many times with theologians and people making discussions, but to be saved from something is to be rescued. And Lord, I pray for rescue. I pray for my family members and my friends who do not yet know you. I pray you would rescue them, just as Paul prays for all of the people of Israel to be saved and realizing they're trying their best. They're working hard, but it's not working because no one can make their way to you. I pray the same for my family and friends, and I pray for my listeners who have people who are far from God in their lives, and we lift up all these people who are far from you, and we dare to ask by the power of your Holy Spirit you would save them, that they would come to the end of themselves in this long journey of trying to please you, or maybe living in the trenches of sin. And Lord, many of us have prayed for people to hit rock bottom only to find a deeper rock bottom. But we boldly pray for rock bottom and the true rock bottom, that they would reach up. They would reach their hand up to you, and you would reach down into that pit and pull them out of the miry clay, setting their feet on a rock, making their footsteps firm, so that your kingdom would be seen and many would see how great you are. We pray for them because of your greatness. We pray for them because of your rescue. We pray for them because we love them. We pray that you would rescue our loved ones. We thank you so much that we are rescued by you. And I'm thankful for this very simple statement of the gospel that in verse 9 it says, if you openly say Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from death, you will be saved. This is something that we can step on as a rock. It's foundational for us. And so right now we choose to live in light of that. We say together, Jesus is Lord. He is God of all. He is part of the Trinity. He is the one who paid the price once and for all, the perfect sacrifice, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world, the atoning one, the one who battled the enemy and won. He is the one who is Lord. And we choose to believe in our heart that God raised him from the dead. We understand that the resurrection is what history is hinged on. We know there is so much evidence for the resurrection, but even so, we just believe in our hearts. We choose to believe that you are a resurrected God living on the right hand of the throne of God, living to intercede for us. This is beautiful, this is powerful, and this is the gospel. We love you, Jesus. I pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. Hey, thanks so much for listening to Pray Every Day. If you want to support the podcast, you can go to patreon.com/prayeveryday. Lots of levels to support it. Also, Pray Every Day is an app. It is free to you, and you can get it on iTunes and Google Play. And if you want to be a part of the testimony episode on February 2nd, you can go to marriedmuth.com, click on the icon that looks like a microphone, and share your story. Thanks so much for doing that ahead of time. I really want to have like 50 stories. So that's me speaking to you, asking a request, and I hope you can do it in these days after Christmas.